Maybe today this desire for more has gripped your life, and as a result, you find yourself frustrated because you want things that you know you cannot have and you cannot afford. Or maybe this desire for more has taken you on a shopping spree that has left you financially strapped. Or maybe this desire for more has driven you into the arms of someone that is not your spouse and you are dangerously close to making David's mistake. Or maybe this desire for more is tempting you to take a job that is not God's will, or to begin a relationship that is not God's desire, or to make a decision that is not God's plan. Or maybe this desire for more has left you dissatisfied and you're ready and willing to walk out on your family, to leave your job, or abandon your ministry. Or maybe this desire for more has just left you empty and you're wondering, where is God in my life? But you see, the answer to our dissatisfaction is to draw near to God. And that begins by allowing Jesus Christ to have first place in your life. In fact, Jesus said in Matthew 6 and verse 33, and this is a great verse, Jesus said, "Seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all of these things shall be added unto you." Seek first the kingdom of God. Put Jesus Christ back into his rightful place in your life, putting first. And maybe for you, this means cutting up the credit cards. Or maybe it means severing that relationship, or tearing up that job resignation, or committing to rebuild that relationship. But you know, for all of us, it means that we are to be listening to God speak to us through his word, and talking to him in prayer and obeying his voice in every area of our life. And friends, it's drawing near. Because you see, if we are drawing near to God, we're going to find contentment. And if you're not finding your contentment and your satisfaction in God, you just might make David's mistake. And friends, that will greatly hurt your life and the life of another for a long time to come. Hey, listen, there is no better thing than you and I drawing near to God. For in his presence, the Bible says, there is the fullness of joy. Hey, may the Spirit of God take the Word of God and bless you with it today.